Arthur.
You don't look so good.
Always good to see you.
Thank you. Reckon I was done for there.
Was he followed?
Excuse me?
Was you followed?
You know you're talking to me, sir.
I ain't sure about much no more.
All I know is there's law whenever you're around.
That's all consistent to me. Since you've been around, stirring things up all the time, getting in Dutch's ear.
She's wherever you wish. There's pigtons and vast. You better watch your goddamn mouth, boy.
Take it easy, cowboy. You're gonna do yourself a mischief.
Micah, shut up.
He started it.
Dutch says we used to go on with plans to create a diversion.
We gotta get some explosives to blow up the bridge.
Keep the army out of here a few days.
I think it's a real bad idea.
I don't think Dutch cares too much what you think.
That's clear.
We gotta confuse him one last time.
Then he and I will head to Blackwater, collect the money, and help everyone leave. He's got a boat lined up.
Blackwater's a fool's errand. Everyone knows it.
Even a greedy moron like you.
It's Dutch's choice, Arthur. You're just a senior gun, same as the rest of us.
Only wait well.
Then you'll do Dutch's bidding.
which is robbing a stage that's coming from Annisburg full of explosives.
Always seem to rob a stage, you mean.
Not me. You two.
I got my own plan to do.
You boys got this.
Shit.
Guess we have.
Come on, Arthur.
And Cowpoke. Take it easy.
You could do with a vacation.
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's go. Mike says we should jump as soon as he comes through Van Horn.
So you're taking orders from him now?
I'm taking orders from Dutch, same as always.
Paranormal coming on here.
You hear about Dutch getting Cornwall?
Hey, hold up a second.
Paint control over there.
Okay, I think we're clear.
Let's head off.
Back to what you were saying.
What needed to be done.
Right now, with the Pinkertons breathing down our necks.
See, I'm starting to think that you've gone soft, Morgan.
Okay, let's hold up here.
Wagon can come from that way. Down from Annisburg, it'll take the two of us to stop it completely, or it'll never get done.
So I was thinking, you go play dead.
I'll take care.
No, I'm the better shot. And you're the better actor. You play dead, and I'll cover you.
I got that.
Oh, that's him coming now, I think. It'll be a quiet show.
Nice drug play.
Comes from
I could easily drink after that.
Yeah, no. Just never go. make any sense to you?
It's a distraction. So it ain't.
Bridge, get a hit near there.
Really does think he's in charge.
Go on ahead.
I need to speak with Arthur.
Good work, son.
What's going on?
Listen.
I know we ain't always seen eye to eye, and you find me irritating and a threat, and I like to annoy you. Right now, I need better from you, Arthur.
Okay, Micah. Whatever you say.
I ain't the bad guy you think I am, Arthur.
But
I am a survivor. Stick with me and you'll live.
Oh, the bridge is probably a two-man job. You should probably go help Marston.
Why don't you?
Like I said,
Dutch and I got planning to do for the train. There's a big picture here, Arthur.
Trust me.
Mr. Morgan?
We could really use some more meat, Mr. Morgan.
Thank you, Arthur.
Don't get Dutch any more worked up than he already is.
I don't know what you mean. Arthur.
You okay?
Why don't you join your old pal, Pearson?
Reverend?
You okay, Mr. Morgan?
I don't know, Reverend.
These are challenging times for all of us.
Yes, very challenging.
You don't seem yourself, somehow. I've always left the Morpheus, sir.
Arthur, Reverend Swanson, would you excuse us a minute?
Of course.
New York? We are going to go to New York. Now, they have been chasing us south and east and west.
We're going to get a boat, we're going to get on a river, and we're going to go north.
New York. Then Tahiti, the Fiji Islands, or this place, New Guinea, dance some girls, freedom. But first we have to make a whole lot of smoke, a whole lot of commotion. And then we disappear.
We need more commotion.
One score and one whole hell of a lot of noise.
We ain't so good at doing scores anymore, Dutch.
Are you feeling all right, Arthur?
Sure, fine.
Pardon me for interrupting. Brought a friend. Hello.
Dutch. This is Eagle Flies. His father's a great chief. Charles and I.
Pretending mercenaries.
We can get more horses.
I know. I understand Eagle Glass is angry, but I don't see how this will help anything.
Especially not with Dutch whipping him up into a frenzy.
Got enough folks coming after us without adding an arm to the list.
Thank you for this.
You going to let these bastards walk all over you?
No, you're not. This is all that's wrong with this world.
Okay, young man, lead the way.
The horses are on a poke near Vanahorn. I have a man waiting for us there with some canoes.
Sure, this could be done without killing anyone.
Of course. What will be, will be. Anyway, son, tell me about this Colonel Favors.
He's a vile man. He and his regiment take pleasure in persecuting us. All the young have been taken from our reservation, shipped off to reform schools. Many women, too. The old are weak and sick, but they deliver it with old medicine and supplies from us.
This ends today. You have my word on that.
Why are you getting involved in this, Dutch?
You know me. We shoot fellas need shooting. We save fellas need saving. Feed them, not this again.
It's been quite a while since we helped anyone but ourselves. And even you know that. I told you, noise.
We need noise, Parker. Noise.
And faith. I still don't know what that means.
Stop questioning and think. Just think for a second. The Pinkertons have had time to reinforce. The civilized world is closing on us. Who knows what else Molly told them? We need to move towards a conclusion now.
Sure, what's this got to do with any of that?
Some good, honest conflict between the army and the Indians might be just a distraction. Kill two birds with one stone. Cornwall was funding the Pinkertons' assault on us. Why do you think I dealt with them? The government is more likely to divert them to other issues, especially if there's one more scandal. Why not say we just need that noise and one more school? You know, I went back for the chest I had hidden outside Shady Bell, and we're close, Arthur. That dynamite, the railroad contract with the army, it was all in those papers Mike found. I have a plan. You just have to trust me.
There's Peta.
These men, like I said, they'll help us.
I got the canoes. The boat is still moored in the channel.
Good.
Come on.
Let's go.
I think the best plan is to paddle up there silently, board, and when we got control, we'll deal with that anchor, float away. We'll be ashore before anybody even knows what happened.
I'm gonna go smoke, alright? Be back in a bit.
Oh!
What the hell?
We're taking back what's ours.
We need to round them up. I'll get these four, Arthur. Can you go after the others?
Okay. Come on. Over here. Come on.
Seems like Uncle Sam likes you fellas even less than he likes us.
So it goes. My father doesn't want to fight again.
Will one of you help me return the horses to my men?
Well, Arthur needs to rest. I will. I like you, son. And after the horses, we're going to wait for the army to come and wreak its revenge?
I hope not.
Of course we ain't. Now let's go check out that fort of theirs.
Is this a good idea?
This is the only idea.
And it is one that will suit both of our purposes.
Stop worrying.
Oh, and Sadie told me about Cone. Meet us at Doyle's Tavern in San Antonio when you can. Shall we go, son?
Certainly.
We'll start some light reconnaissance out at Fort Wallace, and when Combs dealt with, you come meet us there. We'll set up a good spot for you.
I don't know, Dutch.
Yeah, well, I do. This is exactly the distraction that we need.
Your father's fighting was an impossible gamble. There's no winning for you in this.
Father didn't know anything. He'd rather live in ignorance.
Come along, Jeff.
Your father would rather you did not do anything so foolish. I said I would stop this from happening. Would you talk to him?
Big Grange?
Yes. Would you?
I just can't get any more involved in this business, Charles. It's not my fight. You head on back to camp and check on the others, Dutch.
I understand.
Thank you, Arthur.